pretty much it. This is the second version of the helmet. There's a newer version of the helmet, which changes this part up here just a little bit. It has improved cameras that'll be coming out here shortly. But that's it.
Are you impressed with the thing where you can look between your legs and look through the floor in the flight?
It's cool, to be honest with you. I don't really use it all that often. The reason being is that if I really want to see what's underneath me, I'll just look outside. I'll just roll up. Like, it doesn't take much longer for me to just bank up the airplane and look.
Well, you just flip.
Yeah, I just look. If I want to see what's underneath me, generally speaking, I'll just look and see what's underneath me, because I can see it with much higher clarity.
Sure.
Like that camera, it's just an added benefit. That's not the primary function of those. The primary function of those cameras have different uses. That's just an added benefit of it. Generally speaking, guys will use it sometimes. When we fly at night, we use it right now because our night vision camera isn't certified for use yet. So we can use it for flying at night.
Yes.
That's about the only time that I used it. Otherwise, I just roll up and look outside.
What if you need
but
to
I'm
look
also
behind.
Old school. I'm an old pilot. So.
Well,
what about if you want
nothing.
To need to look behind you?
If I need to look behind me, I suppose I could do that, but really, if I need to look behind me, I still have to turn and look. So at that point, and besides, if I'm looking behind me, it's probably another aircraft, and I need to see things with my own eyes to judge range, aspect, closure that you can't get from a camera, from a 2D image. So if I'm looking behind me, I'm just going to use my eyes.
Compared to the F-16, how is your view around?
It's not as good.
Okay.
But nothing is. The F-16, I can turn all the way around and see the opposite side of my aircraft if I want. So it's kind
of... But no cameras or anything?
No. And like I said, I wouldn't be using the camera to look behind me. The F-16, and I'm assuming probably the F-22, just based on it's got a single-piece canopy and the pilot sits high, like, it has really good visibility.
Mm.
There is no better fighter for visibility than probably those two. So it's kind of apples and oranges comparison. So in an F-16, someone should theoretically be able to sneak up behind me. In this aircraft, no one should be able to sneak up behind me. That's the whole point of it. So that wasn't, like, the F-16 was designed for a completely different purpose, and so was the F-22. So when I talk about apples to oranges comparison, like, the F-22 is designed purely as an air superiority fighter, and excellent visibility for an air-to-air engagement was one of the things it was designed with. And so is the F-16. It was a day lightweight fighter that was designed with that. The F-35 is designed to do other things and do other things really well. So
you don't see these things we're talking about as limitations for your for the
if you're flying it correctly and the jet is doing what it's supposed to do, guys should die well before they get behind you.
Yeah.
So that's the bottom line.
Yeah.
If you are in the most advanced fighter on the planet and you let someone get behind you, it's not a jet problem, it's a pilot problem.